Hello and greetings from Iceland. I just got back from a short photo tour to the Reykjanes Peninsula since my 16-day trip ended shortly before the eruption started, which is a genuine Icelandic bummer. So I did another cross-country journey after the eruption started to the peninsula or just a few days ago in order to capture some stock footage from eruption number 7. And as always in photo tours, some things go as planned, others not. Like I didn't get any chance to do any close-ups during this short time frame I had now. But there are, however, webcams taking care of that now. So I decided to focus on the air pollution this time, filming the cloud of sulfur dioxide. But an employee in the Blue Lagoon was hospitalized the other day due to poisoning. So they remain closed, like the hotels around, at least until after the Easter holidays, because the other option would be to send the guests home even several times a week or whenever the wind direction becomes unfavorable. So it would not surprise me if the Blue Lagoon would remain closed until the eruption is over. And one of our experts was saying that it could actually fade out during the Easter holidays, but I'm not sure since it is going still quite strong. And although the air pollution looks a bit dramatic, it is not as big issue as it looks. The Reykjanes Peninsula is a peninsula, and the prevailing wind directions will send the pollution out to sea in most cases. But as for the already suffering tourism industry, this might become an issue. Bookings for the summer are down. It's easy to understand why, although we did not face the same situation during the first 3 eruptions. If something, they promoted Iceland. But this series of events are different now. We went through a human tragedy in Grindavik. And the foreign headlines, they look bad and often incorrect as well. So even though the Reykjanes Peninsula is just a little part of our island, this is affecting the whole tourism industry. In some cases we feel as people are cancelling for the wrong reasons, and with the economy becoming more and more dependent on tourism, we see more troubles coming our way. So let's move to the geology. We are looking at one more strange scenario now. Our problems started with this magma accumulation under Svartsengi, but what we see now is one more version, or continuous flow, from this deeper magma reservoir straight through this sill or reservoir at less depth, 5 to 7 kilometers depth, and straight up to this remaining crater. And we were under the impression for a while that Mother Earth would just finish the job now, through this new and direct pathway to the surface. And we would get rid of those dangerous chapters when the magma chamber at less depth is pressurizing. But it doesn't seem to be the case. The land uplift has started again. So the magma is not just flowing constantly up through the crater. It's also reloading this magma chamber at 5 to 7 kilometers depth. It is slower than usual, of course. And will be so while the eruption is still going quite strong like now. And I don't think that this is good news. I would prefer a steady going eruption rather than to see this magma chamber pressurizing all over again with no clue about how it turns out. And I'm not even sure if geologists have seen such development before. They are at least very reluctant to make any predictions now. And I don't blame them. The odds have not been in their favor so far. This seems to be so unique and multi-layered event that we are looking at. And what we have right now is something that we can control up to some limit, although the lava ponds are testing us from time to time when they take off down to the lava barriers. And they have proved to be very useful. Without them, the lava would have wiped out a big part of the town already. We know that for sure. But instead, the lava has been piling up in front of the barriers, and we all wonder how long they can hold. In some cases, the lava walls have grown to be taller than the barriers, and fresh lava has actually been used to make them higher. So I fully admit that I don't like how things are developing right now. And the town's future is hanging by the thread. There is no other way to say it. And one of the things that makes me wonder now are the sealed volcano formations all over the peninsula. We have over 20 such formations. The largest such volcanoes are built from countless outpourings of lava that can flow for a long way from the summit. Most of those sealed volcanoes are well formed, so it's obvious what we are looking at. While others are more like this sealed volcano here. From the map we see that it is situated just beside the mountain Faradalsfjall that prevented it to become the sealed form that we know, since most of the lava flowed to the north where it formed this coastline. And when I place my drone here and overlook this sealed volcano from this angle, we see how enormous amount of magma those volcanoes can come up with. In this case, around 5 cubic kilometers, 14,000 years ago, and the first three eruptions on the peninsula from 2021 to 23, they took place near the top crater of this sealed volcano that we call Þráins Skjöldur. So my point is, how related are those events to those forces that created those sealed volcano formations? And I'm asking because the first eruption in 2021, it went on for 6 months. And strictly speaking, there has been continuous magma pumping going on from a depth of 15 kilometers for somewhere around 5 months now, although there were some obstacles this time, leading to the forming of magma dike, depression valleys, and more. So I'm talking about this event that is going on now. So I think it's normal to ask, are we going to be looking at a long-term eruption capable of forming a new sealed volcano or finishing the job that started 14,000 years ago around here? And the reason why I ask this is quite simple. All our efforts by Grindavik would be useless in such case. There would just be a mountain there in 20-30 years and no sign of a town that used to be there. But it has to be clear though that I'm the last man to say, let's just leave this up to nature. I will be supporting this lava barrier project all the way while there is some chance for the harbor or the town to survive. And we are actually getting somewhere with that right now. But I do have the feeling though that things might get worse, and not just around Grindavik. It is noticeable how seismic activity is spreading all over the peninsula. It is also noticeable how much seismic activity is around the lake Kleifarvatn. And overall, I feel as Icelandic experts especially are a bit reluctant to talk about the worst case scenario. But that is, however, what we need to talk about around here. And since I've spent so much time on the Reykjanes Peninsula lately, I came back with a lot of footage with questions, perhaps not all the answers, but always questions. So it's plenty to come soon, and with that I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.